This video will be about a recap job, and this is the picture with you of my equipments, two solder stations and one desoldering station. And today we are going to recap Amiga cd32. Just remove these screws you see here. So now I have removed all of the screws, also this cover for the expansion port behind. This Amiga cd32 I just bought in an auction, and it was untested. But when it arrived, I had some problem with it. When I insert a game here and closed the hatch, it didn't spin actually. I had to press down a little bit here. Then it started to spin. So I just made a simple adjustments on this cover here. Inside this area, it's a screw here, you just adjust a little bit. So now that is perfectly fine. Just lift this carefully to the side and bend this to the left, and you have a ribbon cable here. So this is a standard Amiga, yeah, you know, the keyboard cable, like the same like that. So it just pops out. You just lift up this and pop it out. And you have free the CD room system. So now I have unscrewed all of the screws there. This is the first time I ever open a CD32, and you can see these pins need to be bent open, and you don't want to wiggle them too much back and forward because then they will break. So just one careful bend. One here at the top here, and now this top shielding should be ready to come off. So let us get rid of this shield and take a look inside. So this is now the CD32 motherboard. It looks quite clean from my first point of view. Only small dust. I don't see any corrosion around the caps, at least not yet. There is plenty of caps on this motherboard. So we will just take out this from this case and give this a nice clean. Have some something in here and dust. So how do you release this from this board? Oops. Maybe you lift the backside first here. Lift the back side and out, I suppose. Just like so. And there you go. With this CD32 motherboard. So these are the 47 UF. We have 5 of those. We have the 22 UF. 6 of those. And then here we have the hundreds. A lot of them. 9 of these 100 UF. And we have 4 of the 10 UF. And we also have 4 of 4.7 UF caps. And 3 of those. 1000 UF. Another 1000 youth. And this is the 470 youth, which I guess is this one. This one will come here. Those will come here. Yeah, it's like they are. You can see this is flat in the top. But those others, they look like they're going to blow up. So I suppose they are. The polarity is might be wrong there. So we can't see any. You have a good space to come around these caps here. Maybe behind here a little. Maybe only in this area. It can be a little low space. So let's go ahead and do that. Add just some effects. I have put this one there. That's number one. 100 UF. Number two, number three, Special, how do I grab this one? Only a few minutes and we have almost removed everyone. This is a different method from the Amiga 1200 I did, where I desoldered one by one and replaced one by one. I think this is faster way to do it. And I also used much time to clean every single pad afterwards. Now I will just apply more flux and heat it up again and use the solder rig to clean them off and then clean them. So I think this is a much faster way to work. There's only three of these SMD caps left to do. You can see I'm getting more and more confident with the solder iron. It gets easier for each time. And this method heats up the board the less as possible. Using the heat gun, it will burn everything here, and I don't like the idea of that. now let's clean the pads. Preparing a couple of things here. Just looks like in this area it should be a hole through capacitors. But I have chosen to go with the SMD instead. See, it's a hole. Well, maybe it's the other revision. Thank you. source code. be great. I can try to put the other one on soon. Start to solder this one right away. There we go, and then we just cut off the lids. I use this nail cutter and find it very useful for that. What I need to do next is to refill it. Just add a little bit more flux and heat them up again. They have a beautiful solder. So, now I want to check if the polarity is marked the correct way on this board. Let's take a look on this one. I put the light here. You can see this one is marked with the plus and this with the negative. So let's check if that is true. So I have my multimeter here and put it down on the ground here and check if this is ground. And that is correct on the pad. But here on the hole through cap you can see the plus is on this side. And this is ground. But that you can see is wrong. The ground is where the plus is. So now let us check the other one, which is here. The plus is here, it says, and this should be the negative. But it does not have a connectivity. This side has. So those two are wrong. I guess that's why they look so blown up. There is also a way to check them. We will put them the wrong way. Plus is there, but we will do it backwards compared to what it says on the board. You can see now, this is the negative side. And you can see also here, that it's on the grounded plate. So it's correct to put it the wrong way. If this is area is negative, it is green, and also this should be negative. There we go. So, I will just zoom in that area so you can see what I'm doing. Yep. There we go. So, as you see before, none of the cap have leaked. No chance. Also, like I said on the previous video, I have never seen damaged board on Amiga 1200 because of leaky caps. So I don't know what is. Why everyone has such a problem with it, and not me. On the solar on this one go through. This one,
I suppose,
and this one.
So,
this one,
let's go on.
And this one.
And then buy this one.
Here we go. Oh, hallelujah. Okay. Tightest one.
So next one now will be the C4 409 RM.
Okay. Think we got it? So, next one now will be the C4 409 RM.
Now the next one will be C12.
So I think we'll start with this side again. Just like so. Now I think I want to start on this side and continue with this one. Which is 10 microfarads. I think it can be a little tricky one. The smaller they are, the more tricky are. Thank you. But luckily there is only four of them. So, as you see on this board, none of the cap have leaked, no chance. Also, like I said on the previous video, I have never seen damaged board on Amiga 1200 because of leaky caps. So I don't know what is, why everyone has such a problem with it, and not me. So now I will put the cap on this place, I suppose. And there we have one 100 farad cap. One of those. So, let's go ahead and have it out. 147. Also this one is 100. So let's do that one also. Maybe I start with the 47 above here first. I think that will be easier for me. Hybrid something. I'm not sure if that was supposed to be done. Probably not. Okay, this was the 4.7 microfarads. So are those two, I believe. I can't really see what it says. So the next ones here are 47. So what we have left should be 210 microfarads, which we have, and 1 100, which we also have. 100 here and two of these 10s here, and then we are done. What's left then is just to clean over the CD's board. Thank you. And the board is done. Awesome. Okay, so let us take a look around on the job I have done here. Yes. It doesn't look so bad. I have seen worse. It looks actually pretty good. So I'm very satisfied. Now let's try to power on this board. Okay, Forkens, it's now time to fire up this CD32 motherboard. So before we do that, I will just put that to the side so we can show you the newly freshly painted cover shield. This will be very nice to put the newly recapped CD32 motherboard inside too. Everything is cleaned up. Now this monitor is on, so let us just flip the power switch up. And something is happening here on the screen. And the CD32 is working perfectly. So the plastic cover is cleaned. Looks pretty good. The top shield is also freshly painted. Looks much better.
Put the shield back to place, like so. This one broke off. And I'm afraid the other one also will.
Yes.
They really break easy. There we go. So let's connect this back to its place. And flip it upside down to mount the screws and the back cover. So everything is connected here and hooked up, so we are going to test a game on this console. So I have this map here with some burned CD32 games. And I think we are going to try the Shadow of the Beast. That will be a nice test. It's also one thing I didn't do in front of camera. I just used a cotton pad here and gave the laser there a little clean. Just to make sure that everything is in a good condition. So let us just turn on the machine. And turn the volume up or down. Now the CD is spinning. The adjustment I made on this cover previously was correct. When it arrived, before I recapped the machine, when I plugged the CD inside here, it didn't start to spin because this cover didn't close properly. So I had to do a simple adjustment on the side here. It's a screw. You will find it out if you have that issue. So this is someone made this game for CD32. It was not originally released for the CD32. It's all the Shadow of the Beast games in one CD. And I have also added the intro for the PlayStation 4 version, which we are looking at now. Pretty nice. Now I can choose by Shadow of the Beast 1, Shadow of the Beast 2, Shadow of the Beast 3 by pressing one of these buttons. This is the number 1 of the game, then number 2 of the game, and then number 3 of the game. My favorite is number 3. The other two, they are way too difficult. Try a level.
So everything looks good and works perfectly. The only thing I discovered with this monitor is that power switch I had to try a couple of times to make it turn on. So maybe that will be my next video about how looking on that problem and try to repair that. Okay folks, thank you for watching and have a very nice day and see you next time.